also doing very well. We're all well. I hate disappearing, but it happens. It's happened all my life. I just go, so internal, I guess. I don't know. I just don't speak to anybody or go out anywhere or do anything. Usually it's just for a little bit, you know. But lately the energies have been really interesting, and I'm sure all of you are feeling some kind of weirdness. It's been very heavy and very hard to want to even relate to reality. So
yeah.
need to come over here. Come here. Okay, well, we have a few things here to show you. Miss Abby's getting the table all warmed up for us. Because there's squirrels out on the porch driving them cuckoo. Okay, Miss Abby, you want to say hi and give kisses? Come here. No, no, don't, no, don't, no, don't push the camera over. I know you're a good girl. Long time no tap, tap, tap. Go see. So this isn't how it works, Abby. Abby, you have to be over here. Come on. Come on, let's go. Well, while we wait for Miss Abby to sweep the energy for a while here. Sage spray for smudging. You don't want to use smoke. My friend made this. It's so nice. It has white sage, lavender, roses, eucalyptus, and rosemary. What do you think, Abby? Ready? Do you first? Abby's not a fan. That is my favorite. That's delicious. And it feels really tingly. This multi-use table has recently just been holding some nice crystals. I have this humongous Arkansas quartz cluster. This powerhouse that's recently been cleaned and needed to come over here on the table. Just get these instincts once in a while about certain crystals. Don't know exactly what their job is in some instances, but I trust that the energy they're putting out is very inspired and intelligent. Sometimes it's just preparing for me to come back into this area. It's giving me a little bit of Abby feels it for sure, don't you, Abby? Okay, but the camera's there, so you don't want to put your little privates in the camera lens, okay? Yeah. Alright, that feels really nice. So, besides this big honging crystal, I have a few others to the left over here in a basket as well with a lot of tumbled crystals. And Marco seems to be happily laid across some of them, so she's just going to stay there. Abby doesn't know what to do with herself. We're out of practice with the camera here. Come on, turn around, Mama. Okay, just settle down. If you stay right there, I can still see. This is crazy. Okay. And then I have this basket sitting off to the side as well. Okay. We're gonna get thrashed with the tail. Basket. It's handmade by me. A free spirit basket. It's made out of pine needles and raffia, which is a fiber. You use kind of like to stitch it. Little bundles of pine needles as you go round and round and round. Anyway, it's very dry. It's been used for so many different things. But it did really hold up very, very well. And now it's full of rose petals on the bottom. Very dry rose petals. They've been in here for a long time. And then it became a little nest to put all of these little crystal spheres that I got a while back. I don't really have the rings that they can sit on, and I don't want to put them on the table because, you know, cats and all that. It could be a nightmare. Imagine them rolling around all night. And then on the outside, around the edge, I have a lot of the little points that I use for the grid, so just like the way they all fit together and the way they sound. The rest of the stuff is gardening stuff. So, last year I used these. I still have hundreds left. It's like little tongue depressors. And I'm going to write on them the name of the seeds I'm planting. And then I have my tiny little miniature tools that are helpful in planting the little tiny seeds. And I'm not doing as much as I did last year, so I have two trays and it totals 144 places for seeds. bunch of seeds. It all works out very perfectly because I have some that will be going into individual grow bags from seed. So these will just be sprouted in place on the porch. Spinach, carrot, rainbow mix, green salad bowl, lettuce, and some more spinach, broccoli. These seeds are so tiny, tiny. I'm determined to grow broccoli this year. Carrots. These are little fingers. Little fingers. So these will be perfect to grow in the buckets. And these are also very, very tiny seeds. And then I have beets. Cilantro. I think they may be better than the big fat round ones. Could probably grow more of these in the grow bags. And Swiss chard. Rainbow Swiss chard. So, those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One, 3, 9, 10. There's one missing. Other. 11. So these 11 are going in bags directly. So here's, I forgot, also kale, basil, large Italian leaf basil, and arugula. So there are 11 that are going directly to bags, and there are 22 that I'm going to sprout in the house. Is this math putting you to sleep? I just love numbers, and 144 is a significant number. 11 is a master number that's been popping in and out of my life a lot. 22, another master number. Combined is 33. And if you divide the number of cells that I have for seeds, which is 144, by 22, I come up with 6. I can plant 6 seeds of each of these. That'll be more than enough because I really only want to grow 1 or 2 of every kind of plant, if it's a substantial plant, so I don't crowd the bags this year and I'll get a better yield. So I can use this little scoop, and it helps to hold some seeds so I can gently place one or more exactly where I want it. I can use this one to stab a little hole in the dirt at just the right depth for the seeds. This one I can use to loosen up the soil. It has a little serrated edge right there. And that would be helpful in the hard packed dirt. Then the sand would be good for helping to remove plants, or yeah, I guess. I haven't really used that side yet. I want to see what I'm going to be growing. Cilantro. Dill. Thyme, teeny, teeny seeds. Yeah, thyme. I'm gonna try and sprout these indoors. All of these herbs, because I can put some in the front and some in the back of the house. This is mint, garlic, chives. Sage. I really hope I can grow some sage. And some more rosemary. Right now, for herbs, I have oregano and tarragon and parsley that wintered over. So I'm going to add some other herbs in and amongst those plants. And then here are the veggies. Lots of different kinds of peppers. I hope I can grow at least one of each. This is sweet banana pepper. It's very mild. Jalapeno pepper. And they're a little hotter, but not too hot. And then we have a California Wonder pepper, or some places it's called capsicum. I do love those. And then we have another hot one, that's cayenne pepper. And I have some from last year that I dried and grate them up and see how that works in food. And then maybe a plant or two of eggplant. And little cucumbers. Pickling cucumbers. And I have a few trellises. I can have them grow up, get them off the ground. Well, I have zucchini, yummy, and then a few kinds of tomatoes, because, you know, tomatoes are amazing, and they do grow well here, at least that's one thing. So I have heirloom rainbow mix, also fun, San Marzano, which are really nice low acid tomatoes. Good for making sauce. You can have your sauce. And then we have yellow pear tomatoes. These are super sweet. A little bigger than a cherry tomato. And some more zucchini. summer squash. Might try two different types. I've been cooking with a lot of cabbage. It would be nice to have my own homegrown. It would be really yummy. And then two more tomatoes. Roma and beefsteak. Tried and true. So, since it's kind of a crappy day outside, crappy, I will bring the trays over here and plant all these seeds. And I already have over there, where Miss Abby is sitting actually, I have the heat mat, which warms the rooting area, and it improves germination, so everything pops really fast. I have this screen behind me back here that I use as a backdrop, and I am going to be putting that around this table over here that has the heating pad on it, because I don't trust the cats not to mess with my little seeds before they get strong enough to put outside. I also have a very sunny window right there, so in the morning that would be great. So a little forward movement. I've checked in with you and let you know everything's fine. Just following the internal clock or the internal guidance that's telling me I'm not supposed to be doing a lot right now. I'm not quite sure. It's a little bit aggravating, but I'm just sticking to small routines, little lists. I make lists now because sometimes I feel like I'm not doing anything productive. And even though maybe it's a good thing not to always, it helps me to have a list of even the smallest things, like clearing the kitchen counter or taking the trash out or throwing away more crap from the shed that I'm trying to empty out. So I just check it off. Even if it's the littlest things. Because then I have something concrete to look back at the end of the day and say, look, I did two loads of laundry. I got to the grocery store. I took the trash out. Whatever it is. A few things every day. And you realize you are getting things done. And you are keeping up a little bit. And it's okay to just wait for that energy wave to pick you up a little bit more. At least for me, I can't really fight that feeling of mm-mm. It's just mm-mm. And my gut says, I don't want to. And I'm very privileged to be in a place where I don't have to. You know, I don't live a big life, but I have quality time, and my animals are my saving grace, I swear. So I've been spending a lot of time with the dogs and the cats, like I say, going camping. I have started so many videos. I've even put them in my editing software. I probably have about 6 projects started that I just feel that they're not good enough. And it's not even that they're not good enough. They're lovely ASMR videos, but I just can't complete them because that energy is not driving it. And I refuse to throw them away. So I still have a lot of footage, and it would be going back in time to catch you up on everything that's been going on. But I may still make some videos with all of that. If you'd like to see horses out in the desert, horses up in the forest, riding in different places, camping in different places. Not too much going on, but it was very healing and relaxing, and the horses needed it, so yeah. So I hope you're finding your happy place at least once in a while. Maybe have a list of happy things or a list of things that you want to do, even if they're tiny, tiny things. So you can see when you start getting a little tiny bit of movement. But for me, mostly it's been turning my brain off. It's very hard to really, really disconnect, unless I get out of town with the horses, because I usually go places where I do not have internet or social media or even cell service sometimes. So, but I can't run away all the time. And I know you can't either. So, I feel like my contribution in this time of, oh my gosh, so much friction, so much negative energy, is just maybe to share a relaxation with you. It hardly seems like enough. And sometimes I doubt that I do any good anyway, but I enjoy this. I enjoy this time with you. And it is satisfying at the end of the day when I can upload a video for you. I definitely don't want to lose contact with you. So there it is. So, no more promises of these big, extravagant projects that I hope to make for you. I'm gonna scale it back and just get back to trigger videos, maybe sounds, table tapping and things. Even my crystals have been saying, "What the heck? How come you're ignoring this?" Weird time for me. But I'm here. My crystals are all here. We're still having fun. And yeah, I'm just following that energy. So you be well. Stay in touch. And thank you to all of you that checked up on me or just sent me cute little messages. I appreciate that. Nothing unusual, just free spirit going through her little shifts and changes and yeah, growth spurts.